Mountie from Lancaster, Pennsylvania. I'm right back for the Montreal Impact.
Well, now, don't you tell me to smile. You stick around, I'll make it what you want. But never beyond what you can dial. Maybe it's because I'm so versatile. Style, profile.
Hi, I'm Ashley Kleiner, and I'm here with...
Zarek. It's called me Z. It's a lot easier.
Okay. With Z Valentine. I play for BE in Warminster, PA.
Oh, nice.
What clubs did you play for when you were growing up?
I believe the club was called Leeds at the time, but eventually turned into PA Classics, and I've been with PA Classics basically my whole life, just right down the road from where I used to live.
What are some of your favorite memories in playing youth soccer?
Just all the youth tournaments were some of my favorites. Tournaments at Downingtown were always some of the favorites. Not always the best, but we had a good rivalry with Delco. I'm sure everyone does. I'm sure you do as well. No?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So those are everyone's favorite games, you know, those tough interstate games. And just, you know, the State Cup memories are always something, you know, you never forget. The Jefferson Cups, always raining.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Would you change anything about playing in youth development?
No. I mean, obviously the facilities are a lot better. I mean, when I was growing up, we used to practice, I think, indoors a lot at Lanco Fieldhouse, and now PA Classics has their own facility. They have, like, a bunch of fields. I think, you know, Delco's had a bunch of fields. A lot of the teams are bigger now. So, I wish I could play now. I wish I could go back a little bit and, you know, have the things you got.
One of your teammates, Andrew Wellinger,
Wegger,
is from the same area as you, and he was a PA Classic guy, too. Tell us a little about... your playing relationship with him.
Yeah, we actually played together from U11 to basically senior year of high school, which was U18, which is pretty crazy. We were both on Classics together. We were on Leeds, then went to Classics and rival high schools, and now we're playing in the pros together, which is kind of crazy to think about. But obviously, it's nice. We're roommates, and you know, we keep Lancaster together. I had my first Turkey Hill iced tea in a while, so I'm pretty happy about that.
With an older brother that went on and played professional.
Obviously, it's a good resource. You know, he can help you out with pointers. He can, you know, tell you what experiences to have, and just, you know, has a wealth of knowledge that he can pass on to you. And it's just something that's extremely, you know, extremely nice to have.
Do you think it made you a better player?
Yeah, of course. No, I still talk to him before every game and basically after every game. I'm probably gonna give him a call once we leave. But for the most part, it's just it's nice to have someone that I can talk to and knows the game.
Before you made it into
Akron.
Akron, did you envy your brother, or did this just improve that you could play that at that level too?
Oh, there was never any envy. Envy just means, like, I was never jealous of him. I always just was just, I used it as a benchmark. I wanted to do what he did. I tried to copy him. Well, just like every little brother tries to do. So I wanted to, you know, win a national championship, and I was lucky enough to do that, and then he moved on to the pros. So luckily I've done that, and hopefully I can keep going.
In Lancaster,
Manheim.
Manheim, Harrisburg,
our home.
Our home is to some big names in soccer. Growing up there, did you play any of those players?
Yeah, obviously, you know, the big players were Convy, was an Eastern PA guy, Ben Olsen's the big one, and Chris Albright, who actually plays for Philly. So, you know, it's nice to have those guys to set the way, and obviously, you know, you hope to, you know, do what they've done, because they've been with it, fold teams, and, you know, been MLS All-Stars and done good things in their careers. Hopefully I can keep, you know, trying to follow their footsteps.
What makes the area a great place to play?
I think it's just the love of the game. You know, I coach my little sister's soccer team, and just every kid loves to play and they want to get out, and the fields are, you know, in church backyards, or they're in open fields, and it's nice that there's just a overwhelming, you know, love for the game.
Do Did you play in high school soccer?
Yeah, I played in Manheim Township, which is about an hour half away. We are in the Lancaster Lebanon League. I actually played against Downingtown East my senior year in the state quarterfinal. They eventually went on to win, but we gave them a good run for their money.
How was your experience in playing high school soccer?
I loved it. I love playing in front of my friends every day, and you know, I try to draw energy from that, and it was just a good experience, and I'm happy I got to definitely come back from Florida to do that.
How did you like playing at the University of Akron?
Akron was amazing. Obviously, the team was great. We got to win a national championship, and I think the style of play was, you know, good and helped me grow into a pretty good player, I think.
Tell us about the school itself and why you chose to play there.
A lot of my friends went there, honestly, and that's the main reason I wanted to go there. It's honestly not the greatest place in the world, but just a lot of my friends went there. It was pretty close to home, and you know, I enjoyed just my time there for sure.
Do you have any advice for the players that are starting the
recruiting process? I would just say go on visits. You're given a few official visits, and they pay for everything, so take advantage of those. I knew where I was going to go probably from the first time I had first time I went to a school, so I didn't necessarily need to do that. But you know, if you get five, go to five schools. You get a bunch of free meals and some good food, so take advantage of those and go somewhere where you'll be comfortable and you'll be happy. Yeah. My nickname, people call me Z. Just it's pretty simple. Or the foreign players call me Vale, which is basically V-A-L-E, my last name, and with obviously in Spanish or Italian, the V sounds like a B, so just Vale.
Who is your role model and why?
Just my brother. I mean, he set a great path. He accomplished a lot of good things, so I try to, you know, be with him. He's, you know, had a great path, and I just try to, he has a lot of intangibles, which I try to, you know, incorporate in my game.
What is your favorite soccer team?
Favorite soccer team is Fulham. They have a lot of Americans. Hopefully Clint Dempsey doesn't leave, but they have a lot of Americans, so I like to hopefully maybe play there one day.
What is your favorite movie?
I would have to say Happy Gilmore. Watched it today.
What's your favorite song?
Song, that's a tough one. My new favorite song, Blood Brothers by Bruce Springsteen.
What's your favorite book?
There's a Boy in the Girl's Bathroom. I love that book.
What's your favorite food?
Food, it would have to be sushi. I love sushi.
Soccer.
I'd say right now it's golf. I feel that they're getting old. You know, your dad probably watches golf a lot. I think that's me now. I love golf.
What is your pet peeve? What thing makes you mad or drives you crazy?
It's actually in soccer. You know when people wear like the shorts underneath your shorts? Mm-hmm. If they stick out further than your shorts, it eats at me. Like, you know, people like wear their shorts high and they have like the long pants. I hate that. Oh. I make my teammates pull their shorts down just so that it covers them up.
If you could go anywhere in the world, where would you go and why?
Probably Rio de Janeiro in Brazil, just because I saw the movie Rio with all the birds and it looked pretty sweet.
What do you want to do when you grow up?
I'm doing what I want to do now and I'm loving it. But besides that, I'd probably be a SportsCenter anchor. And that'd be the greatest thing for me. Just I'd love that.